We have Nick Branson from the Energy Division, Department of Transport, Energy and Infrastructure. And as you can see on the slide, he's going to chat to us about energy use, rebates, some resources that he has. And so there'll be a bit of information about things you can do at home, but relating it to school and about the education resources. So I'll hand over to Nick.
Thanks. Good afternoon. At the outset, I'll say this doesn't have a lot of direct impact into the school environment. And clearly, I'm aware that a lot of you are here today from the school environment. However, there are a number of parallels to some of the information that we've already had delivered today. And I think we do try and do a bit of energy advisory work with schools anyway, which I'll touch on. But hopefully there's a fair bit of personal information you'll be able to take out of this to try and demystify a number of state government and federal government rebates that are around at the moment. Just to explain a little, the Energy Division has a range of activities, policies, but also an energy advisory service. And this basically comes out of the old Energy Information Centre, which a few of you of a certain age, like me, may remember, sort of ran for about 19, 20 years or so, at different locations around the town. And we used to provide very much a small science investigator centre sort of environment for the community and children to come in and play around and work out what's an evaporative air conditioner, how does it work, and do all those sorts of things. There used to be a lot of school activities that went with that, not so much these days, unfortunately. We are very much sort of focused on the residential part of South Australia, but nonetheless, we try and do what we can. Just to try and set the scene a little bit, and most of you would already be aware of this information. In a typical South Australian home, the key uses of energy are for water heating and heating and cooling. Deliberately, I haven't put on the percentages there because every home is different. It's really just to show you the relativities. So from, I guess, the major use of energy in a home, water heating, heating and cooling, and that's principally why the state government and the federal government are concentrating on these areas in terms of initiatives and rebates at the moment to try and move people into a much more energy efficient way of using those sorts of types of energy at home. Refrigeration freezing is a large part of the pie, and that's principally because 24/7 fridges and freezers are on. Lighting, mention's already been made of things like downlights. Back in the 70s, very much open plan living. You'd have banks of downlights for general lighting. Aesthetics are very good. But as we know, 50 watts per light, if you bring on in banks of 6 to 12 or so, it can really add up in a hurry, and we're still left with a lot of homes that have those sorts of equipment. But one thing I wanted to sort of draw to your attention, and in many ways it's drawn out of the school's environment, is particularly TVs and other. These are two areas which are growing in people's homes. And whilst we're seeing a whole lot of good work happen at the water heating and heating and cooling level in terms of reducing that energy use in the home, these other areas are actually increasing. And if we look at computers, 0.87 computer per household in 2003, it'll be around about 1.25 in 2020. Televisions, we've all seen an increase in LCD and plasma screens, and these use a lot more energy than your traditional TVs. Home entertainment increase in DVD players, game consoles, set-top boxes and laptops. And not only is it having all of those myriad new small electrical appliances in the home, it's also the amount of time that particularly kids are using them in the home, much more sort of lifestyle orientated inside the house these days than ever was the case, I guess, going back into my day. So it's all of these myriad appliances coming in and the time spent using them, which is to some extent counterbalancing all the good work that's happening in some of the other areas. And certainly in the school environment, I'm sure that you can see that sort of myriad number of eligible appliances coming to the home. I can relate a story going back a couple of years or so where I had to go out to a house at Salisbury. There was a letter to the advertiser, can't understand why I'm paying for all the power in the street. The minister got onto us and said, someone's got to go out and see if you can do just a mini audit for this person. Went out there, middle of winter, walked in. Other than the fact that the reverse cycle air conditioning thermostat was on about 33 degrees, and that they had three fridges, one inside, one on the back veranda, and one in the back shed, going as well. It really opened my eyes when you walk into the bedrooms of the three children that they had. They all had a TV, they all had a computer, they all had a printer. They were all on in standby mode. And it just really began to open my eyes to the amount of this sort of equipment that is now in people's homes. And of course, by now, probably most TVs have been changed over to an LCD. So even more power is being used in that sort of environment. just in terms of what we try and do in terms of energy advice within schools, we have a trailer. Jess, who's actually just coming in now, goes out to schools and actually provides a week to 2 weeks sort of training in terms of a range of interactives that are in that. We have a water efficient showerhead, shows how sort of water can be saved using that. We have a whole lighting display in terms of compact fluoros through to LEDs through to normal incandescent lights to show how much energy is used in each of those sorts of things. We're actually now, in fact, in the first term we were out at Richmond, Cowandilla and Plympton primary schools. It went extremely well. This opens up on the roof. It's actually a solar display itself. One of the things we actually noticed and was actually picked up a little earlier on is that we actually get a lot out of student mentoring, and the energy audit teams that the schools have, particularly at a primary school level, is very, very influential, I'm sure, to the other students in the schools, particularly year seven students. So we've actually found working with those teams at a year seven level is really quite good. Even, might I say, perhaps even more so than perhaps with some of the teachers, because again, as it's been pointed out, you know, you can have some teachers who are really into this, some teachers who just see it perhaps more as a chore than anything else. But the kids, by and large, are right across this and really keen to help. I just make mention of the fact, having problems with this trailer in terms of the aspects of safety, portability, storage, maintenance and setup time. So we're actually now considering a more sort of flexible way, a portable way of getting these interactives out to schools. Work with Jonathan and we'll try and get these out into the school environment as quickly as we can. Really, what I want to do now is just very quickly work our way around this in an anti-clockwise fashion and then just explain as quickly as I can what some of these things mean. From a state government perspective at the moment, we have a newly introduced thing called the Residential Energy Efficiency Scheme, RES for short. Basically, this is an obligation on most energy providers in this state, be they Origin, AGL, True, where it happens to be, to actually provide energy efficiency measures and low-income audits for free to the South Australian community. We'll talk about that shortly. From an Australian government perspective, from a water heater perspective, if you're replacing an electric storage with a solar or a heat pump, you can get up to $1,600 or so back as far as the rebate's concerned. From the state government's perspective with water heaters, for a new electric a heat pump or solar, there's about $500 you can get back if you're regarded as a low-income occupier. Ceiling insulation, some of you may be aware, may not be aware, that currently the federal government's offering up to $1,600 to have satisfactory ceiling insulation and up to $1,000 for landlords and tenants. Something new is happening, is coming, it's called Green Loans, it's a federal government scheme. Basically there will be energy auditors who for free will go into your home, assess the sort of energy use in your home. And if there is any sort of retrofitting required, then you could take this no-interest loan of up to $10,000 to retrofit items following that audit. There are other things, and you'd all be aware of the SA water rebates, for example, shower heads, washing machines, you know, you can get up to $200 or so there, various concessions and something called PV solar credits, which I won't go through too much at the moment. Just very quickly in terms of this RES scheme, basically most of the electricity and gas retailers in South Australia are obligated. They're obligated if they supply more than 5,000 residential customers. So all of these retailers here are obligated to provide this service. And the Essential Services Commission of South Australia actually administers the scheme. What is it? It's basically split into two parts. The energy saving measures which these retailers are obliged to provide. At the moment, the specified list of what these energy saving measures are: shower heads, ceiling insulation, retiring second fridges, draft proofing, and energy efficient lighting. 35% of all of that has to be done into a low income environment. In terms of energy audits, these are just to low income households. I'll explain the eligibility in a moment. And 13,000 of these audits need to be done over 3 years. There are yearly targets for each energy provider, and if they don't meet them, there's a financial penalty. What you might see out there is, for example, a number of the providers or retailers on the left-hand side, Red Energy, SO Electricity, Simply Energy, True Energy. They may work directly with householders like True Energy does in terms of offering free installation of lights and showerheads, or they may work through intermediaries like Enact Energy or Field Force to actually provide those services on their behalf. I'll go through this relatively quickly. If anybody's got any queries afterwards, please yell, but I really just want to provide you as much information as I can, as quickly as I can. In terms of the eligibility for low-income audits, basically people need to have a pension and concession card, or healthcare card, or any of the DVA cards. Also, either in receipt of a SA Energy concession or on one of the retailers' hardship programs. Most retailers will offer a case management process if, for whatever reason, you can't pay your bill. They'll help you sort it out. So if you're captured by any of that, then within this scheme, you're regarded as a low-income household and you can get a free energy audit. We'll just go back one if I can. Yeah. So the key thing with REIS is at the end of the day to simply contact your energy retailer and say, what incentives have you got? If you like some of those incentives, then feel free to take them up. They could either be free or heavily discounted. If you don't like what they've got, ring another retailer, because it doesn't matter to them who they supply with these incentives, because they've got targets to meet. They're not targets just for their customer, they're targets across the board. So you can ring any retailer. So if you're with AGL, for example, for electricity, and you don't like the range of things, or they're not applicable to you, you could ring Origin or True or anybody else to find out what they're offering, and they may be able to help you out. Some of you will have heard of renewable energy certificates. These are basically tradable commodities at market price. One renewable energy certificate equals 1 megawatt of renewable generation. A typical solar hot water system will create around 15 to 25 RECs. With a current value, well, it's actually around about $37 at the moment, but if it was around between $40 to $50, that would mean about $1,000 in terms of ultimately a rebate that you would get for putting that system in. Yeah, as I've said, look, it's a very complex issue, but if you are out there looking for these sorts of appliances, then you will come across this terminology of RECs. Hard to get your head around, it's a bit like a share certificate. It is tradable, it does have a market value, and at the moment it's around about $37 to $40. And that'll actually then, I think I've got the next slide, roll through to an example of what this may cost you at the end of the day. So if you were putting an electric heat pump system in, the cost might be $3,900. You could get the $1,600 federal government rebate. If you're a low-income earner, you get the $500 rebate. You'd get the RECs, you know, if it was a typical sort of system of 1,000. So the actual total installed cost would be about $800, which would be even lower than what you get for just changing over your current electric storage system for another one, which you can't do now anyway. just something to, just follows on from that. There are some new hot water rules. Again, some of you may be aware of this. It's coming out in your SA water bills at the moment. So since July 2009, new hot water systems installed in South Australian homes must be of a low emission type. This includes replacing existing systems which are no longer working with some of those. In practice, what it means is if you've got an electric hot water service and you're in the Adelaide metropolitan area, it's hardly unlikely you'll be able to replace that like for like. You're going to need to move to one of those systems, and that's why a number of these rebates are being made available to people at the moment to ensure that the cost is not an impediment to actually doing it. Yep. Just very quickly wanted to talk to you about something. We've developed up an home energy toolkit. This is available in local council libraries. It's in about 100 libraries at the moment. This can be borrowed as a can with a light in the book. We are looking to try and adapt this to the school environment because we think it would work extremely well. It picks up on the PowerMate, which is the appliance that the previous presenter was talking about. You simply plug in any appliance in the home to this. Could be a fridge, you plug it in there, plug that into the wall socket, and by using this here you can tell what the wattage is that it's using, what the cost is, what the greenhouse gas emissions are. So very quickly you can work out across the house where the key energy users are. Other things like an infrared thermometer, you can check the water temperature, which is very useful. I won't bother explaining a range of other sorts of things here, but we found it to be very, very useful, and we think it would adapt well to the school environment. Has a range of literature as well as an instruction kit, leaflet there. I won't talk about the other thing. The other thing is we actually do energy audit training. We have an Energy Friends program where we train community volunteers to actually go out into the community and provide free energy audits. So if anybody is interested, I've got leaflets on all of this on the far side, then we'd be pleased to see you at any of our free training sessions. It actually started from a residents' association, people with time on their hands after work, and they sort of said, we'd like to do something for our neighbours, like to do something for our friends in our local community, what can we do? This was about the time that electricity was being deregulated back in the early 2000s, and so this program was developed from there. So it enables people to actually go into other people's homes and actually provide a free energy audit. Thank you.
That's Simon there. Meters are a great little tool, and we used one in Kisa. Alicia did an audit around our office and found things using quite a lot of power, and we've made a few changes since then, like to save some power, so well worth getting.